Hello everyone, this is Janavi and you are in Study with Janavi channel. So in this video, I am going to tell you the job opportunities after BTech Electrical Engineering. What to do after a BTech in Electrical Engineering? If you grow up fascinated by Nikola Tesla and Thomas Edison and draw blueprints of energy saving toasters and talking TVs for fun, a bachelor's in electrical engineering may be the right career choice for you. But glitches aside, did you know electrical engineers work in almost every industry? You think of from GPS technologies to the army, robotics and filmmaking also. But what's more about electrical engineering? Electrical engineering is one of the traditional branches of engineering which is endlessly adaptable to fields of artificial intelligence and machine learning, given the incredible diverse types of electrical engineering careers. A BTech or BE in this field can be extremely rewarding. But before we look at potential job opportunities in the electrical engineering field, let's ask some basic questions but important questions. First question, what does an electrical engineer do? An electrical engineer designs, creates, tests, and maintains electrical equipment. This equipment can range from simple circuits in automobiles to electric prosthetic limbs to parts of spaceships and satellites. Second question, what is the difference between electrical and electronic engineering? Electrical engineering refers to electrical machinery, transmission and distribution of electrical energy, whereas electronic engineering deals with semiconductor devices such as diodes, bipolar junction transistors. In electrical engineering, major companies in India include public sectors, units like BHEL, NTPC, etc. Whereas in electronic engineering, the major companies are BSNL, VSNL, Tata Consultancy, MTNL, Wipro, Infosys, etc. So what are my career choices after a BTech in electrical engineering? Your career path after finishing your BTech depends on whether you stick to your core discipline, which is engineering and design, or should decide to branch out into non-core fields like management. If you are planning a career in engineering, you can opt for advanced postgraduate study or join the workforce immediately. Can I know my options for further study? Yes, you have many options to select, and the first one is MTech. It is a two-year postgraduate degree offered by most IITs, NITs and other reputed institutions in India. MTech offers you a specialization in your core and associative disciplines. With a BTech in electrical engineering, you can go in for MTech in power system engineering, nanotechnologies, robotics and computer engineering. The MTech entrance requires you to take the graduate aptitude test in engineering, that is GATE exam. You need to write GATE exam for doing MTech. After an MTech, you can teach at a reputed institution, join a research facility, or work in the public and private sector. Depending on your graduating institution and recruiting firm, your starting salary can range from 30,000 per month to upwards 1 lakh a month. Another option is to pursue advanced studies overseas in the form of an MS, Master of Science degree. Roughly the equivalent of an MTech, the MS requires you to take the GRE and TOEFL exams. MS courses in many US universities are often funded, so look out for universities that offer scholarships for you. Some IITs such as IIT Chennai also offer an MS course, which is the gateway to a PhD. Salaries after MS will vary on the country you work. If you work in US, you can expect a starting monthly salary from $8,000 to $11,000. Third option is PhD. Universities in US offer an integrated MS PhD program, while in India and UK universities also offer admissions to a direct PhD program. To qualify for the direct PhD program, you will typically need an M.Tech degree. During and after a PhD, you can work as a researcher and an engineering professor. Salary ranges are too wide to discuss here, but if you start out as an assistant professor at a regional or private engineering college, you can expect a month salary of 40,000 to 80,000 rupees. The fourth option for you is MBA. Now, if you are planning a non-core career, a postgraduate diploma program in management or MBA from a reputable business school or institute such as IIMS is always a great choice for you. You will be required to pass the CAT exam or various other entrance exams to gain admission into a MBA program. Following an MBA, you can work as an analyst, executive manager with Indian and multinational corporations. If you are graduating from a prestigious institute, you can expect a starting monthly salary in range of 50,000 to 1 lakh per month. And can I know what are the job opportunities for electrical engineering freshers? Yes, given the demand for electrical engineers, joining the workforce right after your BTech is a good idea. Work experience will also help you figure out what you love doing in real-world circumstances. Here are 6 career options you can explore right after your BTech in electrical engineering. First one is PSU jobs. Electrical engineering are always in high demand in public sector undertakings such as Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and NPCIL. To apply for a PSU job, you need to take GATE exam. PSU jobs offer lots of perks and a monthly starting salary in the range of 25,000 to 50,000 per month. Second option is central government jobs. Ever since the 6th and 7th pay commission revisions have rolled in, engineering salaries with the government sector pay better than ever. Through the GATE, you can apply for an electrical engineering job at government bodies such as Railways and Indian Space Research Organization, that is ISRO. Starting salaries for assistant engineers range from 20,000 to 50,000 depending on your GATE score. Third option, jobs with armed forces. Whether it be the Navy or Air Force, the Indian Armed Force need electrical engineers to create and maintain complex electrical systems and equipments. After your BTech, you can take the NDA or CDS recruitment exams to join the Defense Forces. And your salary will be 50,000, the basic pay. And you have many more options to get into electrical engineering jobs. Those are electronics engineering, and this pays you at least from 30,000 to 80,000 per month. Automobile engineering, it also pays to 30,000 to 70,000 per month, and also even medical engineering. This will pay you from 25,000 to 70,000 per month. And apart from these career listed here, you can also find jobs as an aerospace engineer, a microchip engineer, and a naval engineer for the merchant navy after your BTech. And thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click on bell icon to get notified.